In this video, I will show you how to get your desktop into Unreal Engine so you can display it in your game or VTubing app. This even works with multiple PC setups. Since we're using NDI for this setup, you need to download the NDI tools as well as the NDI SDK for Unreal Engine. So go to ndi.tv and download and install both. Right now only Unreal Engine 4 is supported, but I tinkered a bit with the files and I got it working in Unreal Engine 5. You can download my build in the description and then simply drag and drop the unzipped files inside the plugins folder in your project. Now before we can work in Unreal, we need to start the NDI tools and screen capture. An NDI symbol should now be in your taskbar. Next, let's launch the NDI Studio Monitor and get the exact name of your NDI stream and note it down somewhere. We will need it in a second.
You can close the Studio Monitor and get into Unreal.
The first thing we need now is an NDI media receiver. So click on Add, Media and get the receiver. Open it, create a new NDI media texture and close it. Now we can create the blueprint to get everything working. So create a new actor blueprint and open it. In there, add the NDI media receiver component and add the NDI media receiver you just created. In the event graph, get the event begin play node and add a find network source by name node and paste the name of your NDI stream in there. After that, get a start receiver node and connect the connection information. Compile and save the blueprint and drag it into your scene so it gets activated when you hit play. Next, we want to create a material so you can apply our screen to some object. So just right-click on the NDI texture and create a new material from it. As you can see here, it just consists of one texture node which uses the NDI texture. Next, you can test if you can get your stream by adding it into a plane in your scene and starting the app.
After making sure everything works, we can now work on making the footage watchable.
As you can see here, I modified the material so it is scalable and movable depending on the object you want to apply to it. I also added the texture to the emissive output with a parameter so we can control the brightness of your screen. You can just copy this blueprint and adjust the values to your liking.
And after tweaking the values, it should look something like this. Bye!
Whee! I'm a Beyblade!